Welcome back. I still have Adeboye Kalejaye and Ogbeni Larry Banjo in the studio. I forgot to ask, Ogbeni is Mr., right?
Yes, but because I did not miss my star, that's why I prefer to be called Ogbeni.
Okay. Let's get to you now. And there's this ministry again that's jamming to the people. We're talking about transportation, a ministry of transportation. We still have a ministry of aviation that's different because aviation should be under transportation. So the Ministry of Transportation should be looking at maybe rail, road, and maybe water transportation.
Yeah.
But here is aviation. So
I mean, the Ministry of Transport?
Yes.
Well, it has to be road, like you said.
Water.
Water. Mm-hmm. And
rail.
Rail.
Okay. So what should they be looking at? What should the ministry or should the minister be looking at immediately?
Well, he has to work in collaboration with the Ministry of Works so that they can fix this road. There are many bad roads in the entire Nigeria. Because how could he do anything if the roads are bad? So I think he needs to work in collaboration.
Let me ask for the benefit of the people that have never applied the Lagos Ibadan Expressway in a long time. You took that when you came to Lagos, right?
Yes.
How is the state of that road now?
It's still bad. We were lucky this morning there was no accident. I mean, but
is it a normal phenomenon that there should be an accident?
I guess in Nigeria, abnormality is normality.
Wow.
I'm sorry to say.
Wow.
But if there's any little scratch or accident, you see, the road will back up.
Mm.
But talking about Lagos to Ibadan Express way, by when you enter Mowe, the road is so bad. So that causes a backup. By the time you get to Mountain of Fire, same thing happens.
Wow.
It shouldn't take them just to patch that road so people can zoom out.
I know.
Especially because of loss of lives.
Okay.
So now
the minister has to work in tandem with the Minister of Works. That's what you said.
Just like I told commissioners for culture all over Southwest, if you keep encouraging our people to speak English, I will have commissioner for culture. Mm. What culture are you going to preserve, or are you going to be working to encourage people to stick to? Anyway, but the Minister of Transport needs to establish some kind of standards in terms of all these raggedy vehicles that we have all over the place. Again, it's as a result of the condition of the people. Because people who don't have money, if they can just buy any vehicle, put it on the road, they want to survive. So hopefully, when the poverty is alleviated, we'll see a change in that. But they need to also work with the National Union of Road
Transport Workers. Yeah.
They need to work with them. I'm sorry to say, I'm a politician now, but that doesn't mean we should not tell the truth.
Mm.
The barbaric manner of Danvo drivers needs to be checked. Not only Danvo drivers, all the public. I mean, right, go to Bini.
Yes.
From Bini to Lagos, you will see how aggressive these will be driving. Like if anything happens, they have Agbe, they'll just take them off their vehicle. Mm. So they need to enforce that. They need to work in collaboration with road safety. Our people, I just don't know. I don't want to quote Fela say our people are senseless. Our people, but how can you? There was a day we were coming to Lagos, and the road to Lagos was blocked, and people were applying one way, and my people blocked that one way again. I mean, they were taking four lanes in that one way that does not belong to you. Instead of maintaining one lane, so that those who are going out of Lagos can go smoothly.
So there should be a reorientation.
Exactly. God bless you for using that English.
And again, these ministers should have their thinking caps. What do you think? Especially the Minister of Transportation. Because while that road in Lagos Ibadan was what did they do? The groundbreaking was being done. Mm-hmm. I was wondering, the Minister of Transportation, we should have liaised with the Minister of Works. Let us try and do rails. We could do light rails on both sides. In as much as we've done the road, to make the transportation easier, there could be light rails there. Or do you think it's not doable?
Well, I want to believe that we're in the era of change, and that we're in a pragmatic government. And we're in a government that appears very responsible and responsive to the yearnings of the people. And it's on that note that I would take off to say that the transport system as it's managed in the past cannot continue that way. While you have identified reorientation and reorientation of our people, in terms of road utilization, road is a resource. It's available for usage. Then its usage cannot be limitless. As you use, there must be depreciation, there must be corrosion, there must be, you know, dilapidation. So there must be continuous maintenance. We had the FEMA, who was supposed to be the maintenance arm of the Ministry of Works.
That's Federal Road Maintenance Agency.
But how well have they done? It's been moribund. It's been a psyche of corruption. It's been, you know, so it's been used as an avenue to siphon Nigerians' money, because they cannot account for, you know, a lot of money that was spent in that very agency. So if that agency is to continue, there must be a proper manager, people who must be accountable to the people. There must be continuous maintenance, that's one, for the roads. And then, like I've also said, we must now look at diversification. And in diversifying, I am aware, I'm conscious, that it requires a lot of resources in terms of finance. And I know that we're not in the best of economics time as a people. Our oil is, the price is falling, our fortunes are dwindling, God forbid. So therefore, these are things that have been done ages before now, diversification of multi-utilization of, you know, access to transportation in terms of our rails, that's in terms of water. How well have we done that? How well can we do water transportation and ensure that there is adequate safety? Because that is the most fearful, you know, means of transportation that is feared by everybody, water. So we must also look at water transportation. What Lagos is doing, people must come and copy, and then we can improve on it. You know, trying to do some kind of water transportation, trying to look at the Lagos-Badagry Express Road as it was conceived. One would have expected, like you said, that when the Lagos-Ibadan Road is the most important road in the entire country. And it's so sad that up till now we cannot fix that road. You want to wonder. It's not only poor people that passes the road. Even the well, the mighty also pass the road. And then, but because they can clear the road, they can do all of these things and continue to blow siren. I think there must be a legislation like we have in Lagos State, where governance in Lagos State has been devoid of use of sirens, where people don't make noise. Like Fashola would say, he would say that when you make noise as members of the cabinet, you are reminding the people that we are oppressing you. You are reminding them of the rules you have not done. So all those sirens, there must be a lot to ban it.
And the roads they have not done that leads to the gridlock, they will still blow sirens
to harass you away from the road. So I think there must be a law banning every public officer, you know, from such a thing. So if we do all of those ones, I'm sure that the enforcement agencies, those who enforce, how well have the
FRSC
done? What do you see them do? They come to the tail end of old toll gate in Lagos. That's where they do their work.
Okay.
They don't go to the inner roads.
Because a lot to discuss, really. And you made mention of culture. Like the he said, if a minister of culture says everybody should speak English, what's his primary responsibility? Let's talk about that ministry. Because one time I saw Ministry of Culture and Tourism. Later I saw Federal Ministry of Tourism, Culture and National Orientation. So I don't even know which of them is the proper one. So I rather just put commerce, tourism, culture, and national orientation together. Let's talk about that together. Ministry of Culture. What are we selling in this country?
I think I'm very, very sorry. I have to be caustic now, because this is about my culture. This is about me being a dignified person, my dignity. I think they are confused.
The Ministry of Culture.
The culture, tourism, and national orientation. How could there be a national orientation when President Buhari cannot go to the UN and speak Hausa, and you will see Yorubas condemning, Igbo condemning that that's not my language. Hausa is my language because it's a Nigerian language. How do you orientate people with slavish mind? That is one. How do you orientate people when you see English, which is a foreign language as your official business. Who says I cannot conduct business in Yoruba?
Yoruba.
That is why every time I call MTN, Glo, or any of these whatever they call them, I choose Yoruba. Not because I cannot speak English, but people don't understand. When I choose Yoruba, I am telling the company that there's a need for them to hire people who speak Yoruba. Mm. Sometimes I don't speak Igbo, I choose Igbo. Mm. So when they come, I say, oh, I'm sorry. But I'm sending a signal. So that is one. Two.
Can I quickly interrupt you and take our first caller? Ogaba is calling from Benue State. Good morning, Ogaba.
Yes, Dr. Good morning, and my regards to your discussant in the studio. I think that, like we always say, we must try to direct this change and not make this change a change of conflict. Hmm. I listened to some of this, your discussants, they are still abusing us, the people. If we have voted for people to go and do a work, and do a job for us, a good job for us, and which they have promised us, what is every time you guys come to the studio, give us the impression that we are that Nigerians are stupid, that we should be holding our leaders accountable? What are you? Are you not? Prescribing anarchy? We don't expect you guys to be taking out this way.
In what instance are you talking about, Ogaba?
That would benefit all of us.
In
the U.S. you have language, so many languages there.
Okay.
The three languages are the major ones in the U.S. A heterogeneous society like Nigeria, we can still do with all our languages. There should be no conflict. We shall enjoy everything we have, both on Yoruba, even in the Southwest. There are so many versions of Yoruba. We still need to work on them and make sure that all of them become very important to our national life.
Thank you very much, Ogaba. Do you want to respond to that?
I'm always amused. I'm always amused when people talk about a system they don't know of, talking about the U.S. Up to tomorrow, the Hispanic is
Spanish
forcing...
And
no, they are forcing the U.S. Congress to accept Spanish.
Yes.
They said English.
Yes.
But you know how they're forcing them? When a Hispanic person goes to the store, it will tell you Espanol.
Even if you go to the bank,
it will tell you Espanol.
Is it that they give you the public announce system in English or Spanish?
So they now force the U.S. Government, and I'm talking the three tier now, the federal government, the state, and the local government. I spent 35 years there, and I work for the government. I know what I'm talking about. The Hispanic now force them to hire them in every aspect. Go to any supermarket, you find Spanish. So they are creating jobs for themselves. My brother, I am not insulting anybody. I am telling you what will help this society. So that is one.
Okay,
so up to today, English is still the word because they believe they migrate from Europe. However, because of all this Spanish, right now, the Spanish even believe they own the U.S. There are a lot of them who are senators now. A lot of them who are government appointees. Because they have a mission. I don't want to digress.
I'll come back to you, but before I go to you, Mr. Kalajali, I have is this Sonny from Lekki? Hassan, good morning.
Good morning, Aluajori.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning to gentlemen on the panel.
Good morning.
I was captivated by the headline, our expectation of our new minister.
Yes.
It's a very broad topic, but let me be very, very brief about Nigeria's problem. Our problem is nothing but lack of sincerity or purpose. Our problem, and within our people, is the problem of unity of purpose. If you are sincere, at home, at school, at work, on the road, there will be no problem for Nigeria. Let all hands be on deck by the ministers. Let them do their work accordingly, with the fear of God, with sincerity. Let there be transparency, accountability, and probity. Everything will fall in line in Nigeria. Forget about tribe, forget about religion, forget about all the primordial sentiment.
Okay.
Everything will work. Our road will be okay. The light will be everywhere. The business, the personal interpersonal interaction of people will be very, very much okay.
Thank you very much, Hassan. Sincerity of purpose. Yes. And that it really makes a lot of sense because, you know, the campaign against Boko Haram, the only advert I'd seen, really, because maybe that's my own perspective on all this, is that we are Nigerians, we are not Boko Haram. But I think the Ministry of Information or the Ministry of, National Orientation now, which is still under tourism, culture, and commerce, should have thought about a different advertisement to put people away from suicide bombing. There are a whole lot of ways to do this, and there are a whole lot of ways to portray us to the people outside. They should have a lot to do. What do you think? That
like,
ministry.
Like we have said, that there must be a rejuvenation of the various ministries, including the Ministry of Tourism, Culture, and what have you.
And National Orientation. And National Orientation.
Mm. Let me also say that it's also a matter of regret that one major, you know, media or platform that has promoted our culture quite sufficiently well, whether negatively or positively, is the Nollywood industry.
Can you do me a favor?
Yes.
Well, you're part of that industry also.
Yes, I am.
Yakub is calling from Dokmemo. Good morning.
Good morning, Dr. Ali.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning to the two wise men in the studio.
Good morning.
Because of the time, the topic is that an agenda for the incoming ministers. Let me set one agenda for one of them. We don't know who's going to hope that particular the power and energy, rather.
Mm.
Because why I'm saying that, therefore, you could agree with me this morning. The whole Nigeria, some of us, or let me even say all of us, we are few citizens. There was a time National Assembly passed a law that big power holding company or PAC, whatever they call themselves, they should stop collecting fifth charge from us. I can tell you categorically today that for they are still collecting that money. When you went there to recharge your meter, they still remove that, they still collecting that money. And then that money collected from you, we don't know where it's going. Now they are not projecting that they want to increase the tariff.
Yes.
So when they increase the tariff, now they still continue to collect the same money. The income minister of power should look into it because
Definitely.
We are free cheated.
Okay.
It's only God might be allowed to help us.
Amen, Yakub. The tariff.
Like I was saying. Yes. Yakub is a regular caller, and it's always been very, very, very
consistent.
You see, like I was saying, that the Nollywood industry has promoted our culture quite substantially, and then in the last administration, we've had a kind of a bubuyaya kind of support in terms of saying there were provisions of, you know, some billions of naira to support
the intervention
fund.
Yes.
We've not really seen the practicability of all of those things. It's also a matter, it's saddening also to say that today, Z World has returned to our screens. We're being reminded of the days of...
Z World is a Nollywood, the Bollywood.
Yes, it reminds us of the days of the Dan Blocker, Michael London, Long Green, the days of the Indian films that dominated our world for so many years. Now they are back in full swing with sponsorship from their own, you know, national government. You know, we've not really have a national government to take charge and support that industry. Similarly, we have also realized that we have not really formulated any policy that promotes our culture. In terms of, look, are we coming now to say, look, for us, for God's sake, we are deciding to have our own lingua franca.
Yes.
To say that, okay, if I don't care, out of all the Nigerian language, Hausa becomes the easiest language to learn. I don't care what it is.
So you just learn one. Like, so I never quickly take a caller or then they. Good morning, sir.
Morning.
Hello, good morning.
Hello, good morning. How are you?
Thank you very much for calling.
This morning, I want to quickly talk about what happened to Amuchi yesterday.
Okay.
I want to congratulate Amuchi and the other ministers that have been screened so far. And I want them to work for the interests of the country. But briefly, for those who have been saying, who want Nigerians to believe that Amuchi is the second name for corruption, I think they should start having a receipt. Now, some of them have never been to River State, nor have any of them seen any document that implicates Amuchi. But because of the hatred they have for him, because of how he worked against the interests of Jonathan in the last administration. They just didn't want to see the man in the cabinet. Even when someone says, Amechi invaded the House of Assembly, he civil the judiciary for 1 year, all of these things for his personal case. Then I want to ask that using 5 legislators out of 23 to impeach 21, you know, preparatory to impeaching the governor, and preparing an in-committee JN to set up an impeachment committee to probe the governor and to impeach him, you know, in whose interest was that?
I wonder that I want to say thank you very much on the day, because we don't have much time and we need to create time.
Like I said, Abiodun has a lot of fans.
Thank you. Yeah, a lot
and
of
like
fans.
I was also trying to say, it's also, you know, quite regrettable that the Z World is back. They've dominated her airways. And then because we cannot also promote her. So I was also talking about promotion of a lingua franca for us as a people.
Yes.
I'm also thinking and I'm also wondering why today we cannot even use our local language to teach in our various schools.
Because we're talking about
culture, tourism, and then the tourism industry.
The tourism,
there can't be a tourism development until when you have a development of the infrastructure. There is a place in Badagry, I don't want to mention it for purpose of advertisement, a tourist attraction where people can relax. But how do you get to that location? The road network is bad. So tourism is not promoted when there is no proper road network, when there is no proper access to that place.
Can I quickly, I have another call, and that's true, because of recent President, was it 2 days ago, yesterday, President Buhari went to Cross River to do the groundbreaking of the super highway, which is part of what you're saying. Yeah. I have the last caller, Dada. Good morning.
Hello, good morning, Mr. Dapo.
Good morning, sir.
And Mr. Kalejaye.
Morning, also, sir.
Mr. Adeboye. You see, the discussion on here now is very, very good and very important. You see, I want to let you know, just a little contribution, that all these things that is happening now is nothing but corruption. If the edge is bad, definitely the rest of the body must be bad. Because I want to portray what Yakubu said. That 750 fixed charge is still being charged by this either Bisco or Disco or what they call themselves. So it's like people don't want to take this thing serious. But maybe I don't want the situation where it's going to result into anarchy. Okay. Because in my area now, I'm still waiting for them. Because definitely I'm not going to pay that 750. It's too outrageous. Okay. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Dada. Okay, as we conclude, he said there should be infrastructure if you want to promote tourism.
No question. But who is a tourist? A tourist is someone who leaves his or her own country to come here. Your Nigerians in America don't even want to come. How can they encourage their friends who are non-Nigerians to come? The children that we have in America don't want to come. How can they tell their friends? My brother, first of all, it must start with our Nigerian embassy. Nigerian embassy, many of the people over there, they are not friendly. Okay? Then, if you pass through all that, you now alight in Muritada Muhammad Airport.
And it's not too friendly there. The airport is not friendly. Really.
Yes. Then, of course, the road. However, I used to promote, let me quickly tell you this. I took Shino Peters to the U.S. one time, and he was dressing in English. A white lady called me and said she will never wash Shino Peters if she doesn't wear Yoruba outfit, because when she comes to see African, they want to see our culture.
Culture.
When we are killing the culture at home, how could the tourists come?
Wow.
Come on, there are many things we need to do.
Wow. We have to round up now.
I like to say that we're in for a new dawn as a people. It's like a restart of our entire nation, our entire being in terms of service, in terms of delivery, in terms of performance. Therefore, our governments, both at the local government, at the state level, at the federal level, cabinet, either in the state or in the federal, everywhere, all hands must be on deck.
We must
decide to take this country forward.
Thank you That's very much, Mr. Adeboye Kalejaye, a public affairs analyst. Thank you very much. And also, Ogbeni Larry Banjo, a three-time governorship candidate Ogun State of, and is of the NCP party. Thank you very much for being part of the program. And that's our program for today and this week. We'll see you next week. My name is Dapo Aruadre. I'm Mr. Yori Folarin, should be here on Monday. I know most of us have missed him. So we'll see you. God bless Nigeria.